Hello, and welcome to our very first As the Valve Moves video. This is a monthly series that we are doing where we answer your questions or any comments you may want to know more about regarding valve and actuation technologies. And we hope that the information that this video series and this particular video will do, you can use in your daily job. I'm Matt Wisniewski. I'm a product manager here at Emerson Actuation Technologies, and today I'll be talking with Dave Atkins. Hello, Dave.
Hey Matt, how you doing?
I'm doing well today. Tell me just for the audience just a little bit about yourself.
So I'm the technical training and development manager here with Emerson Actuation Technologies, working with our partners and our end users on service training.
Neat. So just to start everyone off to level set foundational information here, what is a valve?
So a valve is a device that either restricts or allows flow through a pipe or a line.
Okay. So taking that example just a little further, then what are different types of valves that are out there?
So there are two main types of valves. There are rotary valves and linear valves. And for an example, take your faucet in your bathroom. You have a hot and cold tap for water. And whenever you want to open up the flow of water at your faucet, you're going to turn the lever. You'll have water flowing out. You turn it back, and it closes the valve to restrict the flow of water and close it. That is a rotary style valve. Another one would be the linear style. So think of a spigot or a hose bib at your home, on the outside of your house. You hook up a garden hose to it. That is a linear style valve. So you have a little hand wheel on the valve itself. And as you turn it open, it starts to rise up. And that starts to allow flow of water through the spigot. And when you go back the other direction with the hand wheel, it starts to close. And that will restrict flow and close the valve. So that is an example of a linear style.
Is gardening an outdoor activity you have? You seem to, that's a really good analogy, and you seem to know quite a bit about
Yeah, it's a side hustle that I have.
it. So, in this analogy and some of our industrial type environments that we're in, how does a valve move?
So, an industrial setting, you can, and there are valves out there that are manually operated, just like the examples I just gave you. But if valves start to get larger, harder to operate manually, we can use what's called an actuator to operate the valve.
So, just a little more from that, how does an actuator work?
So, an actuator will take some type of external input to operate it. And we're trying to get some type of rotary or linear motion out of the actuator to operate the valve. And that could be an input from a pneumatic source, hydraulic, or even electric.
So, just to expand a little more, just like we said, what are different types of valves? What are different types of actuators that are out there in the market?
Yeah, so the three that I just described, pneumatic actuators, that's one. It's going to be using compressed air or compressed gas to operate a piston, most likely to move to give you some type of mechanical output from the actuator. Also, there's the hydraulic, which is going to be using hydraulic fluid to move and give you an output from the actuator. And then last is the electric style, where we have an electric motor spinning at high RPMs. Coupled with some type of reduction gearing that's going to give us the mechanical output from that actuator.
So, what is the output of an actuator?
So, much like the two types of valves we talked about, the rotary type and the linear type, we have actuators that match those two types of valves. So, for the rotary type of valves, we have actuators that generate torque. So, torque is a rotational force. And then we have our linear valves, which we're going to have an actuator that produces thrust. So an expand and retract type of motion from the actuator to match those two different types of valves.
Neat. So last question, I promise. So say in the same industrial type setting, how does an actuator help me? How does it optimize my process?
So a good example would be a facility that has a lot of valves, right? We're talking hundreds. Now you could operate all those manually, but that would take a lot of manpower and a lot of people to open and close those valves. So you could use an actuator to automate that process. For any type of power sourced actuator, we can control those through the push of a button to open and close the valves. And that would be a much easier and more cost-effective way to run an operation.
Thank you for the explanation, Dave. I'm sure you can and have in many other classes talked a lot about these topics, but we'll save some of these for other videos that we do in the coming months. And for you all, our video audience, thank you for joining us for our first monthly video series of As the Valve Moves. If you have any comments or questions you would like answered, please leave them in the comment section on the video here. And in there, we also have an email address where you can email questions to us. And wherever you are in the world, have a good rest of your day, and we'll see you again in about a month's time. Bye.